Gotta be wrong.
C.
Look at C. Yeah.
C.
I don't know.
I think Clancy.
Even she said C. Should I conform? Anyone else said it was C too.
C.
I'm sure it's fine.
The title of this experiment is Line, Length, and Conformity. And it was in 1955. The aim of this experiment is to test conformity under non-ambiguous conditions and therefore devised a very simple perpetual task on matching the length of the line to one of three Compassion lines. The independent variable is increasing the group size and whether or not the confederate lies or not. Dependent variable, whether or not the participant conformed. The type of experiment is laboratory experiment.
There were seven confederates. They were meant to act as subjects, but they were asked to give incorrect answers 12 out of the 18 times they were tested, and one real subject. The subject was the fifth to be asked out of the seven participants. Great.
Here are the results for the Asch experiment. 32% conformed, but 74% of participants gave an incorrect answer to at least one of the questions under group pressure. The larger the group, the more people conformed. 26% never conformed, even under group pressure. However, when being debriefed and interviewed, these subjects told the researchers that they felt a lot of pressure to conform. Some of them were quoted saying, "I do not deny that at times I had the feeling, to heck with it, I'll go along with the rest." So, there you go. When another person agrees with the subject, the conformity decreased by 5.5%. The participants who tended to not conform were those who were noted as people with high self-confidence. Three or more confederates seemed to be the most influential among the group pressure. That's the results.
The strengths of this experiment was that it changed the way people thought about conformity, so psychologists and those people, and it also led on to further research, so other people replicated this experiment. And the weaknesses of this lab experiment was that, well, it was a lab experiment, so in the real world, people would probably actually put up a fight for what they stand for in their own opinion, because the matter in which they were debating over would actually be more important than the one about a line. And also, maybe their personality and their own character traits and stuff affected the actual results. So, yes. Oh, yeah, because in the results, it found that it like showed that the people with more self-esteem thought that they didn't have to conform. So yeah, okay, that's it.